And West 2's Jeff Lennox has been live on the coast all week, and this morning, the worst of waves.
Yeah, Jeff, we've seen as the sun just came up, the beaches are taking a pounding there.
They sure are. You know, we're talking about, like Jason just said, 10 to 11 foot waves here along the coast. We're at Cocoa Beach this morning. We're already, some surfers have been getting thrashed around. We see two guys coming out right here. They've been going in and out all morning, trying to take advantage of this high surf. But it is, and we can't stress enough, it is extremely dangerous, this surf, this rough surf here along the Central Florida coast, as Hurricane Earl, this powerful Category 4 storm, passes on by us on this Thursday morning. Now, in addition to those big waves, you also have the dangerous surf again, the dangerous rip currents that can really pop up at any moment. Lifeguards watching out for those really since last Saturday, performing a number of rescues, well over 100 rescues since last Saturday alone. Swimmers again going into this water, this rough water, getting caught off guard by these rip currents, and those lifeguards having to put their lives on the line to go in and save those swimmers. So on this Thursday, the peak of these big waves, lifeguards are cautioning people, telling them if they're a novice swimmer to stay on shore and really just take in the sights and don't go in at all. So on top of all this, you also have some other local concerns, beach erosion, namely local officials keeping a close eye on that as well as this powerful hurricane moves on by. I also know at this point the Coast Guard here in Florida is on high alert right now for any vessels that might be in distress. But again, with seas again around 13 feet, this is not water you want to be caught out in when a hurricane like this passes on by. So we'll have much more on the conditions here in Cocoa Beach, Brevard County coming up at 7:30 this morning. Reporting live in Cocoa Beach, I'm Jeff Lennox, West 2 News.